Moving on, nothing could be finer than to be in North Carolina if Democrat Cal Cunningham beats incumbent Republican Senator Tom Tillis. Tom Tillis is known locally for generally sucking, but he's known nationally for when a member of his staff went viral for showing true empathy.
Over the past 20 years, Bev Veals beat cancer three times. So when her husband was furloughed in March due to COVID, Veals worried about losing her health insurance. She started calling her lawmakers for guidance and came across a Washington, D.C. staffer for Senator Tom Tillis.
You're saying that if you can't afford it, you can't afford it, you don't get to have it, and that includes health care.
Yeah, just like if I want to go to the store and buy a new dress shirt, if I can't afford that dress shirt, I don't get to get it.
Apparently, Tillis is funded by the American Cancer Society. No, not that one. The one that's actually pro-cancer. Tillis's office said they disciplined the staffer, which is disingenuous because Tillis has voted time and again to repeal the ACA, blocked Medicaid expansion in North Carolina, and voted for Trump's tax bill in 2017, which effectively repealed the individual insurance mandate. The mandate was basically what made the ACA possible, kind of like how Jaeger shots and Bloomin' Onions are what made my three children possible. Outback, it turns my DAP into a WAP. Fortunately, Tillis's opponent, Cal Cunningham, has been the frontrunner in the election for months now. Cunningham is known locally for wanting to expand Medicaid in North Carolina, but he's known nationally for that time he ate South Carolina's biscuit senator. R.I.P. Big Biscuit. It was understandable, but also sad. And speaking of sad, Maine Senator Susan Collins.
Republican Senator Susan Collins of Maine is up for re-election, and she is in trouble. In the beginning of 2017, Collins was one of the most popular senators in the entire country, a net approval of more than 40%. By the end of last year, her net approval sat at negative 10%. Enormous shift. She is now the most unpopular senator in the country, with a disapproval rating even higher than Mitch McConnell.
That's both the worst thing you could say about Susan Collins and the nicest thing you could say about Mitch McConnell. Collins's turn as a political pariah has been a long time coming. Over and over, she's teased us with the hint that she might be the only Republican with a conscience, only to vote in line with the rest of the GOP. It's like Lucy promising to hold the football for Charlie Brown, and then when he runs to kick it, Lucy puts an alleged sexual predator on the Supreme Court. Collins has defended Planned Parenthood while also voting to appoint anti-abortion judges. She memorably voted against repealing the Affordable Care Act in 2017 and then voted for the GOP tax bill that crippled it. And she voted in favor of allowing witnesses in Trump's impeachment trial, but ultimately helped acquit him of any wrongdoing. Worst of all, she said she was Team Cardi when we all know she stands Nicki Minaj. Come on, Suze. If you order the beef, you gotta pick a side. Now voters in Maine are considering a candidate who'll do more than just be very disappointed in Trump. Since winning Maine's Democratic primary, Sarah Gideon has beaten Collins in every major poll and seems to be winning over vital independents and undecideds. In fact, Gideon is so impressive, Susan Collins' own attack ad accidentally makes her sound awesome. An attack ad has ended with the candidate who's being attacked saying, wait, did I approve this message? As important as it is to get Trump out of office, it's just as important that we take down ballot races seriously. If Joe Biden does get elected, we still need the Senate and House to pass Democratic policies. A lot of you watching right now are probably like, yeah, no kidding, B-brain. But to that I say, stop calling me names, Tiffany Dombrowski. You think your shit doesn't stink just because your dad owns a Honda dealership and your parents are still together? We are both 50 now, and if I wanted to, I could have you murdered. Murdered all the way. The fact is, we have to expect the worst this election. Historically, Democrats haven't shown up the way we've needed to at the polls. Not in local elections, not for congressional midterm races, and certainly not the way we needed to in 2016. Many Democrats took for granted that the scariest thing we could imagine wouldn't actually happen, but it did.